Hi everyone, welcome to the fourth part of Azure DevOps tutorial. In this part, we will learn how to create and work with the organization in Azure DevOps portal. Let's have a look what is the agenda of this video. In this video, we will learn what is an organization in Azure DevOps, how to create an organization on DevOps, and at the last, we will see how to work with the settings of the organization. What are the settings available for your organization? What can we change, and all these things we will learn in this video. Let's have a look what is an organization in Azure DevOps. In Azure DevOps, there is a structure of your work. Whenever you will be working in the Azure DevOps, you have to work smartly. So you have to plan your work as a structure in the Azure DevOps. What is the structure? This structure depends on organizations, projects, and the teams. So basically, whenever you will be working with the project, ultimately you have to work with a team, and managing lots of projects and managing lots of teams with their roles and all those things, then on top of everything, you have to work with the organizations. You have to plan your work in a structure where you have to work with the organizations, projects, and teams. Let's have a look what is an organization. An organization is a mechanism for organizing and connecting groups of related projects. If you are working in a company and that company has lots of projects, so suppose it has around 1,000 of projects, and if you are using all those projects in the Azure portal, then managing all the projects is not an easy job. So what you can do, you can create multiple groups from those projects, and for each group you can create an organization. So how it will work? On top of everything, there will be an organization. Under that organization, there will be n number of projects. You can associate any number of projects in an organization, and each project will have a team, a group, and all those things that we will learn in the upcoming videos. But on top of everything, there is an organization. To work with the Azure DevOps, you must have an organization. Each project must belong to an organization. Ultimately, you have to work with the projects, and whenever you will work on the project, then you will see that you have to associate your project to an organization. To work with Azure DevOps, you must have at least one organization. Whenever you create an account on the Azure DevOps and you sign in using your credential, automatically one organization is created based on the name which is available in the email ID. One organization is automatically created by default. But you can create more organizations also as per the requirement. But the point to understand here is that you must have at least one organization if you want to work with the Azure DevOps. You can create more than one organization also. That we will see. Now let's see, when should we create multiple organizations in the Azure portal? What is the criteria to create multiple organizations? If you have large number of projects in your company. So as I already told you, if you have around thousands or hundreds of projects, then managing all the projects is not an easy job. You can create multiple groups from your project, and for each group you can create an organization. Even you can have an organization on your company level also, but it is good if you can create groups for your projects, and for each group you create an organization. You can treat an organization as an account. You can create organization for account level, for business units level, sub companies level, or groups level, etc. When you work in a big organization, then for each client, they treat that client as an account, because under that account there are multiple projects which they are working on. So for each account you can create an organization. Or other example is for the business units. Suppose you have multiple business units which are running in your company. For each business unit, you can create an organization, sub companies. If your company had multiple sub companies, then for all those sub companies, you can create an organization, for groups, etc. There are multiple factors. You can choose any one of them as per your thinking, as per your requirement. Each organization will have its own URL. So this is the URL, sample URL of the organization. So ultimately, first there will be the Azure DevOps portal URL, which is dev.azure.com/your organization name. So it means the organization name will be part of the URL. One thing is also clear from this URL, that the organization name must be unique, because it is a part of URL, hence it must be unique. Let's see how to create an organization on Azure DevOps. To work with the organizations, you have to log in into your Azure DevOps account. If you do not know how to log in or how to create an account into Azure DevOps, then you can watch the part 3rd of this tutorial and you will learn how to sign up into the Azure DevOps portal. So now I have already logged in into the portal and here I am on the home page. On the left side, you can see there is a title My Organizations, and under that organizations there is only one organization right now, which is Nithis Web Gentle. This is coming from the email which I have used during the sign up. The email was nithis.webgentle@gmail.com. So it took Nithis Web Gentle from that email and it created an organization automatically. But if you want to create more than one organization, then you can choose another organization also. So let's see how to create an organization. On the bottom part of this page, on your left hand side, there is a plus symbol and it is saying new organization. Let's click on this link. Okay, press continue. Here you will see a pop-up which says you have to give a name of your Azure DevOps organization. So this is a fixed part, dev.azure.com/, and at the last you can choose your organization name. So suppose here I'm saying sample.org. This is the name of my organization, okay? And then you have to choose, we will host your projects in. So basically at this drop down you have to choose a region. So whenever you will be working with the projects, and in the project there will be some data. So the data may be related to the boards, the data may be related to the code, artifacts, all those things. Where that data will get stored, you have to choose a region, and that region depends on your location. So since I am in India, so nearest data center is South India, so I can choose South India over here. You can choose any data center as per your requirement. If you have to work on a project where the client is near about East Asia or the Central US, then you can choose any region based on the requirement. So suppose I am having South India by default, let's leave it and then press on continue button. Don't forget that your organization name should be a unique keyword. Cool. So now we have two organizations in Azure DevOps. Here you can see on the left side, first one is WebGentle sample.org, which we have created just now, and then earlier was Nithis WebGentle. So right now we have two organizations. And here you can see on the right side, create a project to get started. Inside this organization, I can create a project. Working with the projects, you will see in upcoming video of this tutorial, but now we are just focusing on the organization. So that's how you can create an organization. Since we have created an organization, now it's time to learn what settings are available inside the Azure DevOps. So first you have to choose an organization. So here you can see this is little bit bold and this is not the bold. So this is selected by default. Also you can see in the URL dev.azure.com, and here you can see the name of organization is available, which is created automatically. So since we are inside this organization, so I have to click on the organization settings. Once you will click on the organization settings, you will see loads of settings are available under this organization. First, we have a general tab. Here on the left side, you can see all the settings, general tab, security, boards, and pipelines. So let's have a look on all these one by one. First, I'm going to click on the overview. In the overview, this is the name of your organization. You can change the name also, WebGentle sample.org. So this is the name, you can change it also. Then we have a privacy URL. Then we have the description. If you need to enter some description of an organization, because ultimately other team members will also work in this Azure DevOps. So if they do not know about the organization, then to make it clear things for everyone, you can enter a description. And here you can enter the description. So let's add some sample. And here you can choose the time zone. By default it is UTC, universal time zone, but if you want to make it to your local time zone, then you can choose the time from here. Okay, all the time is available over here. You can choose any one of them as per your requirement. Then you can click on the save button, and here we have the region, South India. The region once selected cannot be changed. This region was selected during the creation of the organization. Once you have selected a region, you cannot change it, you cannot update it. Then we have the organization owner. Who are the owners of this organization? So there is only one user which is associated to Azure DevOps right now. So we have only one user, and I am the owner of this organization. If you want to change it, then you can change this also. Whenever you will have multiple users in your portal, then you will see there are some other settings also which are available. Then you want to delete your organization, then you can delete it from here. Delete organization, billing information, all the billing on information of your organization will be available over here. The next is projects. Let's click on it. All the projects which are associated to this organization will be available over here on the right side. So right now we do not have any project, that's why the list is blank. If you want to create a new project, you can click over here, you can fill all the details and you can create a project. Let's create a sample project. Okay, I'm not entering anything. Let's leave all the things which are selected by default and press create. Let's go back. So here I am WebGentle sample.org, and if I click on the organization setting again and click on the projects, you will see a project is available under this organization. So all these details of the project are available over here. Next is users. All the users or team members which are associated to your project are available here. Right now there is only one user, Nitish Kaushik, which is me. So I can see only one user. On the right side also you can see all the users, the stakeholders, everything, all the details of the user will be available over here. Then we have the billing. The billing information for the users is here. So it is completely free for 5 users. We will see the details of the pricing of the Azure DevOps in some upcoming video, but for a sample over here, you can see that the Azure DevOps is completely free for up to 5 users. If you have a team of up to 5 members, then you do not have to pay any amount to the Azure DevOps. All these details of the Azure pricing is over here. Then we have the global notifications. So whenever you will be working with the projects, there are some settings which you need to get. There are some notifications which you want to get. Let's click on it. Here you can see there are multiple settings for the notifications. Build complete. Whenever your build gets complete, if you want to receive the notifications, you can click enable or disable. So by default it is enable. You can disable it also. You can view the details of this notification. You can click on the view to see the details. All these details are available over here. Then we have the pull request. These settings, whenever you will be working with the code, pull request, reviewers added or removed. Whenever you will add a reviewer or remove a reviewer, you want to get a notification. All these settings are available over here. You can see everything by yourself. Then we have the extensions management. Any extension which you have used has been modified. Extensions are requested or requests are updated. All these details related to the extensions. Then release, manual intervention pending, deployment to an owned stage field. We will see all these things when we will be learning Azure DevOps in detail in upcoming videos. So right now I'm just showing you all the details, all the settings which are available under the organization tab. Also, you will be able to understand all these settings in a better manner when you will have a functional project under your organization. Then we have the uses. Here we have a uses tab. Here you can see what user is doing what in the Azure DevOps. We have the extensions. You can, if you need to work with the extension in the Azure DevOps, then you can install that also over here. If you do not have any extensions right now, by default you can browse the marketplace, click over here. So basically these extensions are available to work with third party tools, third party websites. So here you can see code search, Azure DevOps open, analytics. If you want to integrate the Slack in your organization, then you can use this one. Lots of extensions are available over here. You can just have a look, you can browse it by yourself and you can choose any one of them as per your requirement. Then we have Azure Active Directory. Active Directory is basically used to manage your users. You can connect Active Directory to your account to manage the users very easily. Then we have some security policies and the pipelines. All these things depends whenever you will have a working project under your Azure DevOps account. So basically these are some default settings which are available under organization tab. As a final conclusion, we have two organizations right now. One is WebGentle sample.org and the another one is Nitish WebGentle. Now it's time to work with the project, and that we will learn in the upcoming part of this tutorial series. That is all in this part. If you like this video, hit the like button of the video. Tell me your feedback in the comment section. Share this video and subscribe to the channel. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.